Kukuruku.
Ba, ba, kukuruku. Ba, ba.
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 Kukuruku. Once there was a king, and this king was king of just about everything. And when I say everything, I mean everything. He was in charge of making sure the sun went up and the sun went down. He was in charge of making sure that the tide came in and that the tide went out. He was in charge of making sure that the moon and the stars shone brightly at I said, he was in charge of just about everything. Now, this king, he had lots of sons. In fact, he had 16 sons. But he was no longer a young man himself, and one day he decided it was time to delegate, because these jobs and these responsibilities were getting a bit too much for him in his old age. He called the 16 sons and he sat them in a circle, and he started to give the jobs out. You're in charge of the moon. You're in charge of the sun. You're in charge of iron. You're in charge of weather. You're in charge of the sea and everything that lies in it. And so on and so on and so on until he got to the last son, the 16th son, the youngest son. And he looked at him and said, you will be in charge of bad luck. Because bad luck exists, right? So, someone's got to be in charge of it. So this is how it works. Every month or so, the 16 boys, they gather in that same circle. And they show off about all the clever and brave decisions they have made. And their father, the king, he listens very carefully. He scratches his chin and he strokes his beard. Then he gives his advice. And the 16 boys, they listen very carefully. Because their father, the king, he's king of just about everything, so his advice is very good advice. One day, all the boys arrive from the different directions. They sit in the circle and they're already showing off about all the great decisions they have made. And suddenly, their father, the king, looks around the circle and there's something he's not quite sure about. He counts again. And there's definitely one missing, and you know which one. Yes, bad luck. Where, says the king, is bad luck? And the other boys look a bit shifty. I asked you a question. If you know where he is, tell me. And the 15 boys who were there said, oh, we didn't ask him. We didn't invite him. Why not? Because we don't like him. He's bad luck. He may be bad luck, but he is as much my son as any one of you. And so, if he's not here, we are not all together. And if we are not all together, then we cannot meet and we cannot talk. So this is what I want you to do. Search for him. Find him. Bring him back for the next meeting. Do you promise? And the boys, they nodded. But you know what? Do you know what they were thinking? If there's no meeting because bad luck is not there, it's fine because, you see, they'll get to eat the delicious food that their father's cooks will make for them. They can even smell the beautiful, delicious cooking smells coming from the kitchen already. But it was as if their father read their minds and he said, no meeting, no food. Now they realised they'd been punished. They got to their feet. They bowed to their father. And humbly off they went to search for bad luck. Mountains. Huge peaks reaching up to the sky, great majestic canyons. Thundering down into those valleys, there were waterfalls. And along those days they walked.
Og me 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 sera arere owo. Og me 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 sera arere owo. Og me 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 sera arere owo. Og me 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 sera arere owo.
And in those valleys, the rivers were wide and brown. And in that depth swam huge snakes that could gobble you up with one bite. And flying in front of them, huge, multi-coloured, beautiful butterflies as wide as their own faces. And they followed that river all the way down to the sea. Then they got to the sea, and what a relief it was. The sun was setting, there were palm trees where they could hang their hammocks and rest.
Django yamaleko ile, django yamaleko ile, django yamaleko ile. Django yamaleko ile.
And the next day, bright and early, they started to walk inland. And their footsteps led them to a desert with red sand that was blown by the wind into their eyes and into their hair. Noses. They walked and walked until all vegetation disappeared apart from a few scrubby thorn bushes and cactuses. And there, through the heat haze, they could just make out a house. Well, to be honest with you, it was more of a shack. The door was falling off its hinges. The windows were broken. The steps were smashed. And there was a big hole in the roof, so who do you think lived there? Bad luck, of course. They knocked on the door and Bad Luck answered it. And, oh, my brothers, he said, I wasn't expecting you, but please, you're here, come in, come in. Oh, all of you, yes, yes, come in. Then he quickly asked his wife to help him make some food, and the food was prepared and served to their 15 brothers and brothers-in-law. And they ate the food up, and just as they were finishing it all off, they said, oh, yes. You must remember to come to the meeting such and such a place, such and such a time. Don't be late. And Bad Luck said, Oh, yes, I'll be there, definitely. And you're going, are you? Already? Oh, okay, bye. And now suddenly, after all that noise and friendship and community, it was just Bad Luck and his wife. And Bad Luck was hungry and he said to his wife, shall we have something to eat now too? And she says, well, that's impossible, because you see, your charming 15 brothers have eaten every scrap of food in the house. What, says Bad Luck, you mean that there's nothing left at all? It depends, she says. Do you like pumpkin? In the corner, piled high, were 15 pumpkins. 15 big pumpkins that their brothers could not be bothered to carry another step because of their full bellies. And Bad Luck says, fine, I'll have pumpkin. So Bad Luck's wife picked up a big fat pumpkin in one hand and a knife in the other. She raised it high, she brought it down, and with a single cut, she cut that pumpkin in half, and out of it fell gold and silver and jewels and pearls. And Bad Luck said, do that again. She picked up another pumpkin, she cut it in half, and out of it fell gold and silver and jewels and pearls. And every time she cut a pumpkin in half, out of it fell gold and silver and jewels and pearls. So it's meeting day again. The boys come from the different directions. They sit in that familiar circle. and their father watches them, stroking his beard, listening to what they have to say, and suddenly, the one that's showing off the most suddenly stops and stares, because there in the distance, he has seen something the like of which he has never seen. It's a light, but he can't make out what colour it is. In fact, the colour seems to keep on changing from red to blue to violet to orange. It gets closer and closer and closer. A strange rainbow coming towards them. And as it gets closer, he can see that in the middle of all the rainbow colours, there is a man striding towards them. And this stranger comes and he takes his place in the circle. And now they can see who it is. It's bad luck. And now they can see where all that beautiful light is coming from, because you see, bad luck was covered, festooned in gold and silver and jewels and pearls. And the 15 brothers, they stared at their youngest brother and did not understand. Bad luck, he looked at his father. His father stroked his beard and nodded, and bad luck said, "Well, my brothers, what you don't seem to understand is that sometimes, just sometimes, bad luck can be good luck."